Ebola is one of the deadliest viruses known to man. It's named after a small river in the Democratic Republic of Congo where it first emerged in 1976. Up to 90% of infected individuals die from the virus. The African fruit bat is considered a natural carrier of the infection. Gorillas, chimps, monkeys, antelope, and porcupines are also susceptible to catching and spreading the disease. There are several strains of Ebola: Zaire, Sudan, Bundibunjo, Reston, and Thai Forest. They're spread through contact with the blood, body fluids, and tissues of an infected person. Researchers say airborne transmission may also be possible. After an incubation period of between 2 and 21 days, symptoms include severe fever, weakness, muscle pain, headaches, and a sore throat. This generally develops into vomiting, diarrhea, rash, impaired kidney and liver function, and sometimes internal and external bleeding to death. The Ebola virus multiplies quickly, overwhelming the immune system to fight the infection. No medicine or vaccine currently exists.
In the words of John Lennon, he said, "Life is what happens to you while you are busy making other plans." I was born in a very humble home with an ambition to be a banker and live an ordinary life with my family. However, while I was busy making my own ordinary plans, life was also busy preparing me for the challenges ahead of me. June 2014, Ebola was introduced to Nigeria by a Liberian American who came to Nigeria for an international conference. Upon arrival, he became very sick and was rushed to the nearest hospital, the same hospital my fiancé just secured a job as a nurse. No one knew that this man was infected with Ebola until several tests was done on him. But that was too late, because virtually everyone that came in contact with him, including my fiancé, wasn't wearing any protective glove or gadgets. Ebola is an infectious disease and can be transmitted through direct body contact of body fluids such as blood, saliva, or semen of an infected person. This is how my fiancé contracted Ebola on her first day of work. Unfortunately, she died 3 weeks later with a 2-month-old pregnancy. We were expecting our first baby. While struggling for her life, I was there for her. I cared for her. And in the process, I also became infected by Ebola. Fortunately, I survived. I am an Ebola survivor. Being an Ebola survivor gave me a new life, a new name, but with its challenges, stigma and discrimination. I suffered rejection from friends, neighbors, and people I relied on to lead a happy life. I experienced what it means to be an outcast due to a disease or a virus I did not choose for myself. I even lost my job in the process. This is exactly what people living with diseases such as HIV/AIDS and survivors of other infectious diseases, this is what they go through. In my country, Nigeria, they, like me, suffer daily stigmatization and discrimination that people don't want to talk about. Nigeria now has an anti-HIV discrimination law. But like in most of our laws, they're hardly implemented which means it's just there for formality. About 3.2 million people living with HIV/AIDS in Nigeria, with an estimated of 3.5% of adult ages between the age of 14 to 49 that are infected. Very shocking, you say. According to the stigma index of people living with HIV/AIDS in Nigeria, a large percentage of people living with the virus are poor, jobless, without adequate sources of livelihood. They have suffered from self-stigma, leading to shame and low self-esteem. In most cases, they commit suicide. They have been excluded from families and communities due to their HIV positive. My organization, Just Care, envisions a society, a community, where people living with HIV/AIDS and survivors like me of other infectious diseases are not being discriminated. Rather, they are empowered to lead a fulfilled life, to lead a productive life. We want to see a community free of stigma and discrimination. And our solution is based on two major approaches. Our first approach is the use of social media campaign, which will be spearheaded by celebrities such as actors and actresses in Nigeria. This is geared towards changing the mindset of the society on how they see or view people living with the virus. Secondly, we will build an entrepreneurship center that will, from time to time, offer workshops. And the aim of this workshop is to bring HIV-negative people and HIV-positive people together, where they will have an opportunity to share their individual stories. And with the help of a medical practitioner or a psychologist, adequate information, relevant information, will be given to them as regards to their health, the virus, its transmission, and their well-being in general. Our center will also offer entrepreneurship skills, life skills training, and vocational skills. Moreover, after this training, our beneficiaries will be given three options based on their options or based on their preferences. Option one, work in an organization within the community. Option two, work with us as a social enterprise. Option three, become self-employed for those who have the financial resources to do so. Finally, it is also important to note that our venture is not just meant for people living with HIV/AIDS. Our doors are wide open for survivors of other infectious diseases like me, such as EBOLA, tuberculosis, or hepatitis. Within the 7 months of my training here in Kanthari, as a social change agent, a small chili that makes a huge difference, I have learned what it takes to set up a social venture, to creating the change I want to see in my country, Nigeria. Therefore, regardless of the language you speak, regardless of your color or your race, regardless of your profession, let us all put a stop to stigma and discrimination. Because people living with HIV/AIDS cannot change what they have become, but we all can change our attitudes towards them. Thank you.